Hello everyone, welcome to EduStudy. In this video we will discuss current affairs of 19 July. Here besides current affairs, I have included related strategy case and also the additional information of those current affairs. So please watch the complete video. If you are new in this channel, then please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for latest update. Also download the PDF from the description box. In the description box there you will get the link for downloading the PDF. Please go to link and download it. So now let me start. The first question is on your screen here. What is it? Recently, how many new members took oath of office as members of Rajya Sabha? This is the first question. So what is the answer? Answer is here on your screen. This is 7. Okay, that means you have to say recently 7 new members took oath of office as member of Rajya Sabha. Okay, so now we are talking here about Rajya Sabha. So some additional information of Rajya Sabha are given here, which are very important for your strategy case. So try to understand this, keep this remember. First one here, Rajya Sabha. Rajya Sabha is the upper house of parliament of India. Keep it remember, which is the upper house of parliament of India, that is Rajya Sabha. Okay, and who is the chairman? Who is the chairman of Rajya Sabha? The chairman of Rajya Sabha is Vice President of India, and the current chairman is, that means current Vice President of India, he is Venkaiah Naidu. Okay, and the leader of the house is now Arun Jaitley. He is the leader of the house. And leader of the opposition, you must know, his name is Ghulam Nabi Azad. Okay, and how many seats are there in Rajya Sabha? There are 245 seats in Rajya Sabha. And out of 233, okay, out of 233 are elected and 12 are nominated. Keep it remember. You have to keep remember, total there are 245, and out of 245, 233 seats are elected and 12 are nominated. Okay, and limited by the seats are limited by the Constitution of India to a maximum of 250. Okay, so this kind of information we can find from the first question. I hope it is clear for you. Now the first question is completed. So let's proceed to the second one. Now the second question is here on your screen. So it is the 7th Defense Technology and Trade Initiative, DTTI, the abbreviation is this, meeting was held between India and which country? Let us check the answer. Answer is here US. That means you have to keep remember, there was the 7th Defense Technology and Trade Initiative, DTTI meeting, that was held between India and US. Okay, this is the answer. Answer here is US. Okay, so this is the part of Indo-US bilateral defense cooperation. Okay, this DTTI is the part of India-US bilateral defense cooperation. Sorry, not corporation, I'm sorry, really cooperation. The meeting was co-chaired by Secretary Defense Production Dr. Ajay Kumar. This is most important, you have to keep remember. The meeting was held twice a year alternatively in India and the USA. Okay, and whenever we talk about USA, we know its president, he is Mr. Donald Trump. Okay, but we don't know about the vice president. You have to keep remember, vice president of US is Mike Pence. Okay, Mike Pence is the vice president of US. So now our second question is completed. Let's proceed to the third question is on your screen here. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs decided to increase the fair and remunerative price FRP of wheat crops for the 2018-19 marketing year. Okay, now you have to tell the name of the crops. What is it? It is the sugar cane. Okay, keep it remember, it is the sugar cane. That means the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs decided to increase the fair and remunerative price of sugar cane for the 2018 and 19 marketing year. Okay, some additional information of this question is given here. These are the minimum price increased by rupees 20 per quintal to rupees 275 per quintal. Okay, this is, you have to keep remember, as per the recommendations of the Commission for Agricultural Cost and Prices. That means this decision was taken by the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs according to the recommendation of the Commission for Agricultural Cost and Prices, that is CACP. Okay, So now this is our, this was the our third question, and third question is already completed. I hope it is clear for you. Let's come to the, so this is the fourth question here. It is, name the vice president of Google, Southeast Asia and India, who took an additional responsibility of the Delhi NCR chapter of the Indus Entrepreneurs, TIE Delhi NCR, as its president. Okay, so let us check the answer. Answer is here, Rajan Anandan. Okay, Rajan Anandan is that vice president of Google, Southeast Asia and India. Keep this also, remember, this is also a question. It is important here, who is the vice president of Google, Southeast Asia and India. That question may be asked in your any kind of examination. So you have to keep remember it. And he took an additional charge of responsibility of the Delhi NCR chapter of the Indus Entrepreneurs, TIE Delhi NCR, as its president. Okay, his name is Rajan Anandan. Okay, now here our answer is Rajan Anandan. And some additional informations are here. Prior to Rajan, the president was Pramod Bhasin. Okay, TIE Delhi NCR is the most active and highly rewarded chapter of TIE to nurture the Indian startup ecosystem. Okay, so this kind of information we can collect from the fourth question. So fourth question is now completed. I hope you have cleared it. So let's proceed to the, I'm sorry, this is not fourth one, this is the fifth question. Now fourth question already completed. Now fifth question is here, Walmart with which tech giant is teaming up for a strategic partnership that will get more advantage over rival Amazon in both technology and retail. Okay, so let's find the answer. Answer here is Microsoft. Okay, you have to keep remember, Microsoft is the answer here. That means Walmart with Microsoft, okay, Microsoft is a tech giant, is teaming up for a strategic partnership that will get more advantage over rival Amazon in both technology and retail. Okay, and the agreement is for 5 years. Okay, this agreement is for 5 years, keep it remember. And Walmart will use Azure and Microsoft 365 across the company for its new projects. Okay, according to, this is according to the agreement. Okay, this will happen. So we are talking about here Microsoft. Okay, as we talk about Microsoft, we must know its CEO, chief executive officer, his name is Satya Nadella. Okay, and the headquarter of Microsoft, you have to know what is, where is the headquarter of Microsoft. Headquarters of Microsoft is Washington DC. Okay, and we are also talking about here Walmart Inc. Okay, its founder is Sam Walton. Okay, he is the founder. And where is the headquarters? Headquarters is in Bentonville, US. Okay, and president and CEO, he is Doc McMillan. Okay, so this kind of information we can collect from the fifth question, and it is completed. Now let's proceed to the sixth one. Okay, sixth question is here on your screen. Name the javelin thrower of India who has clinched a gold medal at the Sotteville Athletics meet in France. Okay, now you have to name the javelin thrower of India. Okay, let's check his name. His name is Neeraj Chopra. Okay, Neeraj Chopra is that javelin thrower of India who has clinched a gold medal at the Sotteville Athletic meet in France. Okay, so some extra information is here given. He secured the gold with 85.17 meter throw. Okay, and silver medal was won by Andrian Madre of Moldova. Okay, and bronze medal won by Edis Matusevicius of Lithuania. Okay, now we are talking about here France. Okay, so we are discussing about France, so we must know its capital. Its capital is Paris. Okay, Paris is the capital of France. And who is the president? President of France is Emmanuel Macron. Okay, who is the prime minister? His name is Edouard Philippe. Okay, Edouard Philippe is the prime minister of France. So this kind of information we can collect from the sixth question. Let's come to the seventh one. Okay, seventh question is here on your screen. Name the person who is said to be named the Save the Mission of Asian Games from India. Okay, let us check the answer. Answer here is, his name is Brij Bhushan Saran Singh. Okay, this is the answer. Keep it remember. And regarding this question, we have some extra information here. He is the president of Wrestling Federation of India. That means Brij Bhushan Saran Singh is the president of Wrestling Federation of India. This is most important question as your examination point of view. Keep this. Remember, Asian Games 2018. Now we are talking about Asian Games 2018. Some facts you must know. The host city will be Jakarta and Palembang in Indonesia. Okay. And motto, what is the motto of Asian Games? This is not only for Asian Games 2018, it's for the complete Asian Games. It is energy of Asia. Okay, nations participating, that means how many nations will participate in the Asian Games 2018? There will be 45. Okay, 45 nations will participate in the event. Okay, and the event will be, how many events will be there? There will be 465 in 40 sports. Okay, so this kind of additional information we can collect from the seventh question. I hope it is clear for you. Let's come to the eighth one. What is the eighth question? Eighth question is here on your screen. Which digital payment company of India has acquired POS platform Job for Retail? Okay, so let's find the answer. Answer is here, PhonePe. Okay, it is the PhonePe. That is, PhonePe is the digital payment company of India which has acquired POS platform Job for Retail. Okay, so we are talking about Job for Retail. It is a hyper local point of sale platform for small and medium businesses. Keep it remember. Okay, Job for, so as we talk about here, as we discuss about the Job for here, it's you must know its CEO, he is Neeraj Jain. Okay, and the PhonePe, we are also discussing about the PhonePe. So its parent company you must know, it is the Flipkart. Okay, Flipkart is the parent company of PhonePe, and founder and CEO of PhonePe is Sameer Nigam. Okay, and its headquarter is in Bangalore. Okay, so this kind of information we can collect from the eighth question. Okay, let's proceed to the ninth one. So ninth question is already on your screen here. Which day is celebrated as Nelson Mandela International Day 2018 internationally? Okay, this is the question. So now the answer is here on your screen. This is 18 July. Okay, so 18 July is celebrated as the Nelson Mandela International Day 2018 internationally. Okay, so here's some extra information regarding this day. That means 18 July, Nelson Mandela International Day. This is the 100th birthday of Nelson Mandela. That means, so from this question you can keep remember that Nelson Mandela was born in 18 July 1918. Okay, this can be keep remember through this question. Okay, that's why this is the 100th birthday of Nelson Mandela. The Nelson Mandela Foundation dedicates the day to acting against poverty. This is also most important. UN General Assembly declared the day. Okay, so this kind of information we can collect from the ninth question. Let's proceed to the 10th question. So it's on your screen. With which search engine the UNEP has entered into a partnership to monitor the impacts of human activity on global ecosystem? Okay, the answer is here, Google. Okay, Google is the answer. That means with Google search engine, the UNEP has entered into a partnership to monitor the impact of human activity on global ecosystem. Okay, so now we are discussing here about the UNEP. What is its full form? Its full form is here given, United Nations Environment Program. Okay, this is the full form of UNEP. Keep this remember. And its headquarter is in Nairobi, Kenya. Okay, and the director, who is the director of UNEP? The director of UNEP is Eric Solheim is the director of UNEP. Okay, so these were the 10 important question of current affairs. So besides this current affairs, questions of current affairs, we have some extra one linear. So keep this remember here. Some extra informations are given here. India and Indonesia signed a MOU on cooperation in the field of pharmaceutical products, pharmaceutical substances, biological product and cosmetic regulatory functions. Okay, so this agreement, this MOU with India and Indonesia. Second one is here, European Union and Japan have signed an economic partnership agreement, EPA, at EU Japan summit in Tokyo. Okay, third one is, Indian captain Virat Kohli suppressed AB de Villiers to become the fastest batsman to score 3000 ODI runs as skipper. Okay, so let's proceed to another one, that is fourth one is here. India lost the ODI series against England 1-2. Okay, and fifth one here is new 9 more teams will play Ranji Trophy in 2018-19. And sixth one is here, Google faced a record European Union antitrust fine of 4.3 billion euros over its Android smartphone system. Okay, so this is the current affairs of 19 July. I hope this video will be very beneficial for you. If you think so, then please like the video, share the video and comment on the video. Whatever you find difficult here, confusion here, please write on the comment section. And please subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for latest update. Thank you for watching. Thanks a lot again.